As late as last week, Ben Roberts-Smith still hoped to know by Christmas the outcome of his massive legal gamble.
Do you think you'll get a result this year?
Well, I thought the case, hopefully the case can be completed this year.
No chance. Today, Judge Anthony Bosanco said it is too early to know when the multi-million dollar trial might end, dismissing a plea from Robert Smith's legal team to at least have closing arguments by February. More than 40 witnesses are still to be heard, including Robert Smith's ex-wife Emma and his former lover. Both will give evidence against our most decorated living soldier, as will some of numerous witnesses who served with him in Afghanistan. Today, his legal team challenged a key Afghan witness who says he saw his uncle Ali Jan being handcuffed and kicked off a cliff by a big foreign soldier. Last week, Bruce McClintock SC said, "You want compensation, don't you, Muhammad Hanifa, for the events of that day?" "Brother," said the witness, "I'm not concerned with money." But today, another Robert Smith barrister, Arthur Moses SC, referred to a WhatsApp transcript in which a third person said the witness had spoken with the Afghan Human Rights Commission, which told him some compensation would be provided if Australian soldiers had wrongfully killed his relative. Arthur Moses concedes the transcript amounts to hearsay evidence, but says it goes to the credibility of an apparent eyewitness to one of the worst war crimes being alleged against Ben Roberts-Smith. Another witness to that alleged crime admitted on Friday he had poor eyesight and the events were up to 300 metres away. Lawyers for the Nine newspapers say photographs of the village show the distance was more like 100 metres. The case is now adjourned until November. Hugh Rimmington for 10 News First.